Hi everyone, this is Lawrence from the Woodland Factory Robotics, and today we have a CAD tutorial and we will be building an FTC drivetrain. This is what we will be building. It has 6 extrusions and 4 ultraplanetary motors, and all the parts are from REV Robotics. You can load them from revrobotics.com. So let's get started. First of all, we want to make sure that our units are in inches. So you come here, you click edit, change them, and click inches, and okay, mine already inches, so it doesn't let me change them again. So these are the parts we'll be using: a Mecanum wheel, an extrusion sketch, the motor with an axle, and the ultraplanetary mounting bracket. So the first thing we're gonna do is gonna put some parameters in here. These are basically gonna be our dimensions. The first one is the width of the extrusion, and this one is in millimeters, right? So I'm gonna type 15 millimeters, and then I'm gonna put them all. This is the length of the drivetrain in the x-axis, that is 15 inches. And then this is the length in the z-axis, sorry, of the drivetrain, which is the same, 15 inches too. Then we have the length of the extrusions that are parallel to the x-axis, and this will be same as x length. And then the length of the extrusion parallel to the z-axis, and this is actually z length minus 2 times W extrusion, and we'll see that later why it's not C length alone, is because we have to account for the width of the extrusion. We'll see that later in a minute. Now, the distance of the brackets, of the motor brackets to the extrusions, and that is going to be 1.6 inches. And lastly, the inner gap, and that's around 9 inches, 8.9, that works. And there we go. So now the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna model these extrusions here, right? And so I'm gonna save this in case something happens. Right? I'm gonna import the extrusion sketch. I'm gonna close this and this is fine. So I'm gonna extrude this. And I'm going to start making the Z extrusion, and that's so this is going to have the length of the extrusion, right? And I'm going to create a new component, actually. So now here we have this component, and I'm going to name it the extrusion. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to ground it because I want to keep it there, so now I'm not able to move it, right? Now I'm going to do the same for the x-axis extrusion, right? So in this case, I want a new component, and the distance is gonna be x extrusion, right? Which is less than 15 inches, right? It's 15 inches. The one that is less than 15 inches is the one we did before, which is the z extrusion. And the extrusion, okay. Now we have it here, and I'm gonna call it x extrusion. Right, so yeah, let's see. Okay, so we have both of them. You can see that I can move the X one, but I cannot move the Z one. That's because the Z one is grounded, and you can see it because of that orange pin there, right? So now I'm gonna assemble those, right? I'm gonna make a joint. So first of all, I'm gonna move this one there, and then I'm gonna put a joint in there. Let's see if this works. Yeah, perfect. And now this one can't move, right? None of them moves because this one is locked to this one, right? They're fixed together. And this one here can't move because it's grounded, right? So none of them move. So now I'm going to do the same thing in this side, right? So I'm going to get this extrusion. I'm going to click move and I'm going to create a copy. So now I have another one, and I can technically hide this one because I'm probably not going to use it anymore. So now let's create another joint. I'm actually going to do there and here. Okay, and this doesn't work, right? We don't want this. So what I'm going to click is flip, and this one is the one we want. So if you see something that doesn't look like what you want, you should always try to flip it, or you can rotate it, right? But in this case, rotating doesn't work, so we just flip it around, and that's what we want. Now we're going to move this one. Well, we're going to create a copy and put it in this side. So that's the Z extrusion. Move and well, they're gonna let me move because it's grounded, right? So I'm gonna have to unground it, then make a copy, and now ground it again. And actually, yeah, I moved it out by accident, but it's not a big deal. Actually, it doesn't really matter where the two extrusions are, because the joint is gonna move it, right? So I can just, even though it's flying, it doesn't change anything. I just click in there. Now I'm going to the other side. And I think it's here. Okay, see? Okay, and that's perfect. So now we could make a joint here, but we don't need to because it's already fully constrained, right? It doesn't add anything. You could do it if you want. I'm not going to do it because it takes time. And also, it doesn't add anything to the design, right? So I think this is fine. Nothing moves because this one is grounded, but if I'm ungrounded, right, now everything moves together, which is what we want. So I'm gonna ground it again. And now we actually need, I'm gonna save, wait, save it. And we need the other two extrusions that go in here, right? And those are this two, this one, and, well, not this one, this two, right? So to do that, I'm going to make copies of this, and then move it to the center and create a joint. So this is the extrusion. I'm going to choose this one. I'm going to create a copy, and then move it here. Now I'm going to do the exact same thing. Create copy, and move it back there. And now, I know the distance between these two because that's the inner gap dimension, right? So I'm gonna create a joint between those two so that I set a distance in between, right? Because now I can move it like that and say the distance between these two is inner gap. And now they are free to move, but they will move together, maintaining that inner gap that we chose. And now I'm actually gonna put a joint between this one and this one here. I think it doesn't matter if you do it between this one and that one, or this one and this one. As long as you do it with one of them and this one, it will work. So I create a joint. Again, I'm gonna choose pick that point. And now I'm gonna pick a point that is gonna be in the center of that, right? So well, then actually, I'm gonna try something to see if it works. Did I pick the center? Yeah, I picked the center, so I'm here. I'm gonna pick the center. Okay. Let's see. Okay, that doesn't work, right? So I'm gonna change my point in the extrusion to get something that matches that one, which is this one here. Okay. There we go. Now when this works perfectly, right? And the distance here between the center and this extrusion is actually going to be inner gap divided by two, right? Because inner gap is from here to here, so from here to there is inner gap divided by two, right? And there we go. I'm gonna save it. And now I'm gonna make sure that it's actually true, that this is right, so I'm gonna measure that the distance between these two is actually the same distance as those two, right? So I'm gonna click the measure tool and I click this face and that face, right? And I get 1.8 something, right? 1.87, and I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. See if they are equal, which they should if we did everything right. And yeah, they match. So we are basically done with the extrusions. So now we're gonna make sure that everything moves together, and it does. So good job, everyone. I'm gonna save it, and I'm gonna grind it. So that's for the first part of this tutorial. Hopefully you guys now know how to assemble the extrusions together to get this shape. So thank you for watching.